student, today we are here to discuss and revise chapter number 1 in social science. This is Earth's rapid falls. Now students, first of all we will discuss some words that are very important for us. First is rapid, it means context. Second point, it means figure and spot. The rows, it means line. Column are tall, vertical posts made of stone. Now students, I am going to explain Earth's reference point. First of all, I will explain the imaginary line. Then students, what is the imaginary line? Imaginary lines. These lines do not exist but are drawn on globes and maps to help us locate a place easily on the earth. Imaginary line. These are the imaginary line. These are the imaginary line edges but are drawn on globes and maps to help us locate a place easily. These lines locate a place easily in the earth. Some important imaginary lines are latitude. The horizontal imaginary lines are called latitude. Horizontal imaginary lines are called latitudes. Now in between, equator divide our globe in two parts, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Equator, this is the equator. Equator divide our globe in two parts, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now students, today we are discussing about the latitude. Latitudes are the imaginary line. This is very important imaginary line because the horizontal imaginary line are called the latitudes and they run parallel. They run parallel. That is, they are the same distance apart. They are measured from 0 degree to 90 degree. They are measured from 0 degree to 90 degree. The 0 degree latitude is called the equator. This is 0 degree, it is called the equator. And it passes through the center of the globe. It is the passage of the center of the equator. Center of the globe. It is called the equator. The equator divides our earth into two parts, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Latitudes in the northern hemisphere are drawn 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 and so on. Okay, latitudes in the northern hemisphere, this is the northern hemisphere, this is southern hemisphere. And latitudes in the northern hemisphere are marked 10 to 90 degree. Latitudes in the southern hemisphere are marked 10 to 90 degree. It is the same. Now, student, apart from these lines, the other important lines of latitudes are in north. Apart from these lines means northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. Apart from these lines, the other important lines of the latitudes are in north, Tropic of Cancer, Arctic Circle, North Pole. In north, Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer at 23.5 degrees north. And then after Arctic Circle on 66.5 degree north, North Pole at 90 degree north. In south is the same. Tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degree south, Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degree south, and South Pole at 90 degree south. So students, these are the latitudes. Latitude means akshansh rekha. Latitude, the horizontal imaginary line are called latitudes. And some important latitudes are Tropic of Cancer, Arctic Circle, North Pole, or ending south, Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle, South Pole, etc. Now some important imaginary lines are second longitudes. The vertical imaginary lines are called longitudes. The longitudes meant at the poles, where north to south. So longitudes meant at the poles. Longitudes are measured from 0 degree. prime meridian. The prime meridian. This is the prime meridian. Prime meridian divide Earth into Western Hemisphere and Eastern Hemisphere. Now, students, prime meridian divide Earth into two parts: Western Hemisphere and Eastern Hemisphere. So, students, longitude do not run in parallel. Now, listen. Longitude. These are the longitude. Longitude do not run parallel to each other. Since Earth is spherical, because Earth is spherical, longitude are closer together at the poles. Here, these are the poles. It is north pole. It is south pole. So, longitudes are closer together at the poles and further away at the equator. So, where is the equator? Where is equator? This is the equator. So further away at the equator. So students, these are the longitude. So students, rotation of Earth and longitude help calculate the time in any place on Earth. What is the use of longitude, latitude, imaginary line, rotation of the Earth and longitude? Rotation of the Earth, you know, our Earth is rotating and it is rotating on west to east side, okay, and it makes day and night. So rotation of the Earth and longitudes help calculate the time in any place on Earth. Clear, students? Now here we discuss about the heat zone. When Earth orbit the sun, when our earth orbit the sun rays fall vertically. When Earth orbit the sun rays fall directly on the area around the equator. This is the area of equator. This fall directly. So when Earth orbit the sun rays fall directly on the area around the equator, making it the hottest and it is closest to the sun. That's why the places in this area are very hot. Clear to all? When Earth orbit the sun rays fall directly on the area around the equator, making it the hottest and it is the closest to the sun. That's why the places of this area, equator, this area, very hot. The sun rays do not fall directly. Cover the distance, huh? So the sun rays do not fall directly as we go away from the equator. When we go away from the equator towards the pole, these are the poles. It is a north pole and this is south pole. So students, the sun rays do not fall directly as we go away from the equator towards the pole, so it is closest at the poles. To understand this distribution of heat better, Earth is divided into three different heat zones. Now, students, rotation of the Earth and longitude help calculate the time in every place on Earth. Got it? After that, everybody know Earth is still. It is still on its axis and its surface is curved. Curve means curvilinear band. To mark our head, when Earth orbits the sun's rays fall directly. When the Earth orbits the sun's rays fall directly on the area around the equator, making it the hottest as it is the closest to the sun because it is a plugging. ये चौड़ा है बीच में से हमारे अर्थ का पोर्शन. So that's why it is hottest and it is closest to the sun. That's why the places in this area are very hot. The sun rays do not fall directly as we go away from the equator towards the pole. So it is closest, coldest at the pole. Now again, as we go away from the equator, जब हम equator से दूर जाते हैं, poles की तरफ जाते हैं, it is और ठंडा होता है, पोल्स के लिए दूर होता है. टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, study about the heat zones.
Okay, students, to understand this distribution of heat better, it is divided into three different heat zones. These are the three kind of heat zones. Heat zones is an area of land which is a particular characteristic. Got it? Okay. Now torrid zone. Torrid zone is on equator. It is hottest zone or which the sun rays fall directly. Torrid zone is hottest zone. This is the hottest zone.
Ask me all the things in doubt class. Thank you so much.